Rogers, Oregon Realtors Director of Legal Affairs. July 1st is the end of Oregon's eviction moratorium, sort of. Today, I'm going to highlight where Oregon landlords stand with respect to tenancy terminations and evictions come July 1st. This is not legal advice, it's just a summary. And remember, your local jurisdiction may have additional requirements. First, 90-day termination notices are still allowed when a seller has accepted an offer from a buyer who intends to move in as a primary residence. Remember, these notices must state the reason for the notice, and sellers must provide the tenant evidence of the accepted offer. Landlords who have an ownership interest in 5 or more dwelling units must also pay a relocation fee of 1 month's rent along with the notice. Second, no-cost terminations of tenancy are back. Landlords can now terminate a tenancy in the first year of occupancy with a 30-day notice. And landlords who missed their window during the moratorium, the legislature gave you a reprieve. If the first year of occupancy ended during the moratorium period, landlords have until August 31st, 2021 to issue a no-cause termination notice. Third, terminations for non-payment of rent, fees, and charges that came due during the emergency period of April 1st, 2020 through June 30th, 2021 are prohibited until March 1st, 2022. This is the grace period. And remember, anytime a landlord sends any notice to a tenant related to an emergency period balance, the landlord must include a written statement that eviction for non-payment of rent, charges, and fees accrued during the emergency period is not allowed before February 28, 2022. Fourth, terminations for non-payment of rent that comes due on or after July 1st are allowed, but only if the tenant has not notified the landlord that the tenant has applied for rental assistance and has not provided the landlord a declaration under the federal eviction moratorium, which ends on July 31st. Landlords must also include with any notice of termination for non-payment a new notice prescribed in statute that informs the tenant that they are protected from termination or eviction for 60 days if the tenant has applied for rental assistance. And remember, until March 1st, 2022, landlords must apply any money they receive from tenants first to current rent, fees, and charges before applying it to the emergency period balance. Finally, for-cause terminations and evictions for reasons other than non-payment are allowed. Well, that's a quick summary of the status of evictions and terminations come July 1st. Visit our website for more information, and remember, talk with an attorney before taking any action to terminate a tenancy. We'll see you next time on the Risk Management Minute.